I'm inspecting this rear subframe bushing. These are the ones that may just go bad, but the car has only 120,000 miles, so it's fairly recent. It's not high mileage. Basically, what you want to see, you need to remove a plate. Let me just show you. This is what the plate looks like. It has 240 millimeters and one big bolt. And it's better to, I think, do this with the welds on the ground, all four welds. Basically, I just want to see these rubber parts here, both sides are not cracked. I cannot see if they are soft or not, but at least they shouldn't be cracked or even worse, broken. Interesting to notice these rubber parts are located laterally, so actually they keep the subframe from moving laterally, but it won't really support it front and rear wise unless it hits these bump stops. But it has some play when you for the subframe to move front rear. Basically, this is where the people do those inserts actually to rigidify the thing. I'm not sure I'm going to do, perhaps yes. One thing to be aware is that, like I said, there are two bolts at the rear here and one big one. These things, especially the inner bolt here, may just get some water grease on it. Really need to keep them clean because you need to tighten properly. Otherwise, the bracket will move and will make a knocking noise when you brake at low speeds. And finally, just position is not the best. I just want to show you something. I pull it. These are the subframe bolts. Theoretically, this needs to be replaced when you remove them because they are stretched. So this is one that seems in good condition, but look at this one, how much the rust has eaten. You see right there at the top, it's just not exactly the whole width of the bolts remaining. So hopefully they are not stuck in there, but if you see this, replace them as up. Don't take a chance to put them back in place. And the same should be done on the other side, the other bushing. The front ones should be fine, but it's mostly the rear ones at higher miles, maybe 200,000 miles and up. They may go bad. It's also good perhaps to get those inserts before they go bad, so you just prolong their life actually. And you notice I'm supporting the subframe with the ball jack. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully this helps you guys.